Hi, this is Dr. Thomas Inge, Director of the Bariatric Surgery Center and Chief of Pediatric Surgery here at Children's Hospital Colorado. Today I'd like to tell you about an exciting new study that was just released. This study is entitled 5-Year Outcomes of Gastric Bypass in Adolescents Compared to Adults. Metabolic and bariatric surgery is known to be effective in reversing severe obesity in adults. These operations are most commonly performed in the fourth or fifth decade of life, but there's not been a good head-to-head comparison of outcomes of surgery in adults compared to adolescents to determine if the outcomes of these operations are different when they are performed earlier in life compared to later in life. We were particularly interested in understanding whether teenagers would maintain their weight loss to a similar extent as adults over 5 years, and whether the teenagers might have a different likelihood of reversing type 2 diabetes or other cardiovascular health problems after these procedures. So in this analysis, we examined the outcomes of gastric bypass surgery in a group of adolescents compared to adults who had sustained obesity since their own adolescent years. All of these patients were participating in NIH-funded studies. There were 161 teenagers in the study with an average weight of 323 pounds, and there were 396 adults with an average weight of 325 pounds. After gastric bypass surgery, the adolescents and adults experienced excellent weight loss. The teenagers' weight was down by 26%, and the adults were down by 29% on average. Now, in terms of health measures, we looked at type 2 diabetes and high blood pressure in particular. We looked at those with diabetes at baseline who reversed the diabetes, and in other words, were able to control their blood sugars without any medications. We found that 86% of the teenagers, but only 53% of the adults, experienced remission or reversal of their diabetes. This was significantly greater remission in the adolescents when compared to the adults. The other interesting analysis that was done looked specifically at medication use for type 2 diabetes. At the conclusion of 5 years, none of the teenagers were on diabetes medications, and more than a quarter of the adults were still taking medications for their diabetes. We also looked at important cardiovascular health measures, in particular, high blood pressure. Here again, when we specifically calculated the remission of high blood pressure, we found that 68% of the adolescents experienced remission of their disease, whereas only 41% of the adults experienced remission. We found that at 5 years, 1 in 10 teenagers, but 1 in 3 adults were still on medications for high blood pressure. Again, a significantly greater improvement in the younger patients. This study also took a look at adverse outcomes as well. We measured the number of patients who had surgical complications and required additional operations, and the patients who died over the period of 5 years. What we found was that 3 of the adolescents and 7 of the adults died within the study period. The cause of death for the teenagers included overwhelming infection in 1 case and drug overdose in 2 cases. In the adults, 3 deaths were due to surgical or medical complications around the time of surgery, and 1 death was due to suicide. Another death was due to colon cancer. For another 2 deaths, no cause of the death could be determined. We also examined additional operations that were needed within the 5-year study period. We found that the adolescents underwent additional operations at a higher rate than the adults. The types of operations seemed to span the spectrum of operations that are usually seen after bariatric surgery, and it was not exactly clear why the teenagers had a higher rate of additional operations, since there was no unusual operation that could be linked specifically to the younger age group. We also looked for differences in vitamin and mineral status in the two groups over time. In particular, we looked at deficiencies in iron, vitamin B12, and vitamin D status over 2 years. We found that at 2 years, almost half of the teenagers, 48%, had low iron status as measured by serum ferritin levels, while only 29% of the adults had low iron status. This was significantly different. We didn't find any differences when it comes to vitamin B12 status between the groups, but when we looked at vitamin D, we found that the adults had better levels of vitamin D also at 2 years. We speculate that these differences could be due to differences in compliance with vitamin and mineral supplementation regimens between the age groups. I believe that the most important finding to come from this research is the better understanding of diabetes and cardiovascular outcomes when surgery is used in youth compared to adults. These teenagers with severe obesity and diabetes are at particularly high risk for the development of additional early health problems related to their underlying disease. And those health problems include blindness, kidney failure, cardiovascular diseases, problems with pregnancy and childbearing. This has been Dr. Thomas Inge coming to you from the Center for Children's Surgery at Children's Hospital, Colorado. Thanks for joining us.